Hello everyone, a very good afternoon to you all. All roads leading to Tokyo and the Olympic Games next year. But who out of the Netherlands and Pakistan will make it? The first of two matches this weekend here at the Wagenaar Stadium just south of Amsterdam. The Netherlands men's team looking to join their dominant women's team in Tokyo. Their coach Max Caldas has once before guided the women's side to Olympic glory, but the men's team haven't struck gold in 19 years in Sydney in 2000. But for Pakistan, they stand in their way, a team who haven't played a competitive game since the World Cup nigh on a year ago. A real test of where they are, with the Netherlands determined not to be slipping up against them here today. This is the schedule. Spain and France will go again later on in Valencia. Brilliant game that was yesterday at 3-3. And then Canada against Ireland later on this evening should also be a cracker of a tie. They have been piling in, and they are hoping for an iron sellout crowd here over the weekend. Two nations with great hockey history, dating all the way back to just after the Second World War. And hoping that we're going to have some real entertainment here over the weekend. Before the teams do emerge, let's get the thoughts from both camps.
Yes, Max Caldas, a big match for the Netherlands, really important in a crowded Wagenaar Stadion. Can you already feel the tension?
No, I think we love playing at home. We love playing for our own home fans. We enjoy playing those games, so today's no difference.
About your preparation, are you ready for it?
Yeah, we're always ready for it. Sometimes we're better prepared or not, but we're always ready, and we're ready.
What kind of match do you expect?
I think a game where we're going to try to impose our game, and we're going to try to defend with big numbers in the middle of the pitch and get on the break. So we spoke about that, so we'll be fine.
What kind of a result do you expect for today? Do you want for today?
I think we see every game as a game on its own. So today we're going for the win, as always, and it's not a difference. We're going for the win.
Thanks, good luck. It's been a while for Pakistan to play such an important match. Are you ready for it?
Definitely, we are ready, and no doubt it's a big game. And the Netherlands, they are the best team in the world. For us, we also, you know, come here to play good hockey, execute best individual skills and team tactics, and give best performance. That is our objective, and you know, may the best team will win.
The Netherlands, the best team in the world, from Kwaja Janae. I think Belgium might have something to say about that, along with the world rankings, but certainly the Netherlands, by far one of the great nations, and will be certainly in Tokyo if they get there. They will be one of the main threats for gold, no doubt about that. And always expectant in front of this bumper crowd wherever they play. Here in Amsterdam they are. And Pakistan emerge first. They've had a tough time of it in recent years. They didn't even qualify for Rio. To go back to 1984 in Los Angeles, the last of three golden triumphs at an Olympic Games. But an almighty test of character for them here today. A breezy afternoon in Amsterdam to try and deny the Netherlands their own place in Tokyo.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome and give them a big hand, the team of the Netherlands!
Listen to this roar. Led out by their captain, their skipper, Billy Bakker. Team packed full of experience, flair and goal-scoring quality. And they'll be hoping for fireworks over the next 2 days. Twice Olympic champions. Team emerge. And our on-field umpires are already out there. Cambasso and Sean Rappaport are two on-field umpires. As always, before we get going, the two national anthems. Great noise innovation. And they're all ready to go. Mohammed Rizwan Senior, the captain of Pakistan, Billy Bucker, of the Netherlands, and confirmation again of Dan Barstow and Sean Rappaport, our two officials from England and South Africa, respectively. So I'm looking at the teams for you then. Tremendous quality throughout this Dutch team. Vast majority who played their part in finishing third in the Pro League and also with the Euros this year. Look out for the goals of Mirko Preuser. A real threat in front of goal is Mirko Preuser with Brabtefoot. He's been a recent call-up for Jaron Hertzberger, who misses out through injury. Floris Vortelboer on the bench, making his 50th appearance today, he hopes. Some clear messages getting put across there, isn't there? And Pakistan, can they upset the odds today? We just see Mohammed Rizwan Senior leading this Pakistan side with a real mix of youth and experience. Humaputo also another important cog in their machine. Coach Junaid believing not giving 100% means you can't expect miracles. Well, it would be quite a story should they get the better of this Dutch team this weekend. Maurits Visser getting the nodding goal to start today. Permin Black in reserve. Max Caldas, one of the most passionate, heart on your sleeves kind of coaches you will get in any sport, really. A terrific character. And it's his team that get us underway here in Amsterdam. The Wageningenstadion, which was the home of the finals weekend of the Pro League. Great joy for the Netherlands, a women's team coming through and winning the inaugural Pro League in the women's competition. The Netherlands want to settle for third. Pakistan in their familiar green and white. The famous orange of the Netherlands. To keep Pakistan close into the corner here. It's difficult for them to break out. Real test of character and where they are, really, Pakistan, with the lack of matches that they've been playing, competitive matches that they've been playing. They dropped out of the Pro League just before it got underway. And they had a couple of warm-up games with Germany most recently, the last few weeks, and both matches they had 6 goals put past them in heavy, heavy defeats. Happy for things to be playing on. Was at an Olympic Games in London in 1948. First meeting between these two. Pakistan won 6-1. How he would take just anything today, really, to keep them in the contest going into the second game. Khwaja Junaid was a former Olympian himself in 1992, the Barcelona Games. Really back at making some ground, but then having to go backwards again. First cries of Holland sounding around the Wageningenstadion. Seven and a half plays it forward, but able to reach a target. Always passionate and always very quick to get the ball forward. Happy for things to carry on. And taking a risk, Pakistan. Very nearly intercepted by the Dutch. Such high expectations that they get the job done over this weekend. They did meet, incidentally, at the World Cup. The Netherlands were resounding winners.
Because of high risk of turnover, I'm just going to sit deep here. Right?
Yeah.
And it's very...
Because of the three high hangers, I'll stick out.
Rare there. That these two sides fail to produce in terms of goals whenever they come up against each other. Just an innocent a trip. I don't think Robert Kemperman knew too much about that. Needs 2 goals for 50, Robert Kemperman, incidentally. It's Poyser at the other end. That he might have got a free hit go his way. Kemperman's hurt himself here.
Yeah, okay. Right. Okay. Hand and then
now
stick,
missing Göran
yeah?
Hertzberger through injury. Strike of the hand, which will be a sore one.
Right.
Spoker, in terms of creativity, is a big loss to the Netherlands. And also his goals as well.
Now. Yeah, he's fine.
Taken down safely by Thierry Brinkman. Pakistan forced into the corner. Find a way out here. Forced all the way back to the baseline.
Using your body.
A Dutch ball. Just a bit of hold ice on that hand that has been whacked.
You see the guy at the back post.
Kemperman. 207th cap today.
14.
Make some ground on that right flank. It comes off it. Here come Pakistan. Get to cause some issues for the Dutch defence. It's just a little slip. The free hit goes Pakistan's way. Vortelboy needs to get back. Relevant meters and a first penalty corner will go Pakistan's way. So encouraging. Vortelboy, who makes his 50th cap today for the Netherlands. So first real test of this Netherlands defence.
Captain, on my whistle, please.
14.
10
14.
Seconds.
Careful with the handle.
Defence.
Sorry, nice one. Were you like that?
Yeah. Marshall by the likes of Sander Bart. Hamid Rizwan with the injection. Trap is good, and the finish is even better for Pakistan. What a start. Inside the first 5 minutes, they profit from their first penalty corner. It is beyond Moritz Visser in a flash. Mubashar Ali, have some of that, he says. Oh, what a story this could turn out to be. Previous appearances before the Germany matches, like for many of these players for Pakistan, for the World Cup. Just to see just where they are in terms of match sharpness. Those two matches against Germany will have helped in that regard, not in terms of confidence. They get six put past them in both of the warm-up games. For their first threat from a penalty corner.
Yeah, yeah. You find that.
And first blood belonging to Pakistan.
Yeah, today, okay.
From Mubashar Ali. Well, they are playing with fire here. That's a really good save from Amjad Ali. Well, if this is a taste of what is to come throughout this contest and tomorrow as well. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. It is never dull between these two. catalogue of errors there that could have led to the equalising goal. Charlie looking to bring it down and able to do so. What is the response to be like from the Netherlands? Twice Olympic champions, three times World Cup winners, eight times Champions Trophy winners. A nation dressed in success. Hasn't happened for a while. And what can they make of this opportunity here through Kahneman? It'll just be a long corner. Sammy Van Ass. Taken down by Terence Peters, hoping for more from the officials. Pakistan have the chance just to calm things down a little here.
Okay, we're playing. I know that we've been in the
fight,
but
yeah,
either you played on, you'll
build
that early.
Yeah. I mentioned what they've won in their history, the Netherlands. Those are the five times that they have been crowned European champions. For the next European Championships in 2021 will be on home turf. They played here at the Wagener Stadium. And he goes, well taken, really nice build up. Valentin Verka.
We're playing.
think you will see. It's just how quick the Netherlands are in and around the edge of the circle. But he's lightning fast. But they've been stunned a little bit here from the start from Pakistan, who don't seem to be overawed by being here. And playing in front of a passionate full house against one of the very best nations. To work something here, that come off a foot, the umpire says no, little ball goes to him, is Ayash Ahmed. That will definitely be a free hit for the Netherlands. Might have gone his way. Ali Shan. Pakistan just calming things down a little after the expected onslaught that would have come from the Netherlands after they had gone behind. So a test of their mettle as well for the Dutch. Scored plenty of goals against Pakistan. Last five meetings, incidentally, they've won the last three out of those five. 2014, the last time Pakistan beat them by 4-2. And that run of three matches and three victories, 4-0, 4-0, 5-1 victories. Fairly convincing. Taken down safely, but legally, here is Mohammed Rizwan. Mambut. Sticking a peg in there was Floris Vortelboer, man from Breda. Max Caldas on the sidelines. Argentinian. 18 caps for Argentina, two Olympics in 1996, 2004. Yeah. Career ended through injury. Kemperman. Start again here for Glenn Schurman, although he has to go all the way back. Mink van der Veerden. To spread things, and in the end it will be a decision that goes the Netherlands way. Sammy van Aas, penalty corner. And the high fives, the burst.
Stick tackle,
the reason. All credit to Sammy van Aas here. Proper eagle eye at these umpires as it happens so quickly. De Verden is one of the great threats from a penalty corner. An absolute specialist. Here they come looking to respond. It was Jip Jansen. They'll get another one. Second opportunity here from the set piece.
Guys, don't worry, I've got it. You can stay out of it.
Jansen, the first option. Back off a Pakistan stick. Penalty corner awarded again.
I have to hold there.
Here they go again. The injection, the trap, the execution was poor. Not one of their finest moments, and Pakistan look to try and catch out the Netherlands. Abdul Rana, still he goes on. And pickpocketed, and here come the Netherlands. Direct, straight through the heart of this Pakistan defence, and the chase really is on. Was there a little pullback there, perhaps? I think that's what Thierry Brinkman is appealing. Well, the final touch actually came off a Pakistan player, so long corner it is. At high intensity from the Netherlands to try and break down this resistance of Pakistan, who lead as we enter the final 2 minutes of the first quarter. Stopped in his tracks is Uma Buta. Qualifier, first of two matches, remember, being played at an outrageous pace. It's all going to be played out over two matches. If you're not familiar with the qualification process, two matches, and it will be an aggregate score that will determine who goes through. If they are to be level and aggregate after the second game tomorrow, a shootout will be needed. Mubashar Ali gets the free hit. For Uma Buta.
The ball, we need the ball, please, the ball.
Final minute we have entered. Mohamed Rizwan. Uma Buta, oh, goodness me. That was a coming together.
Earlier,
have a look at this again.
Moves
through and
very careful.
I don't think anything could really have been done by Valentin Berger there to get out of the way in time. When he plays his trade in Amsterdam, Valentin Berger, Argentinian born, Buenos Aires. Hola, Alejandro, former Olympian in 1988. That should be that for the first quarter. There we go. So, advantage Pakistan. For many, it wasn't in the script. And they have rattled the Netherlands, most definitely. And they have taken their chance when it has come their way from their sole penalty corner. And Pakistan have the lead through Mubashar Ali. Wonderfully executed penalty corner. And plenty to think about in the early stages here for Max Caldas. Netherlands 0, Pakistan 1. Great crowd in, as usual, for the Netherlands. And Pakistan with the early breakthrough. Mira. From a penalty corner, dispatched with absolute precision. And Mubashar Ali, a few hairy moments for Pakistan, but the Netherlands have just not been able to break through. And there's been a resilient defence. All of their quality, and they've had penalty corners that they've repelled well. So far, so good for Khwaja Junaid. It's a new coaching team. And I say new coaching team. Khwaja Junaid wasn't that long ago when he was the coach and it all came to a disappointing end for him after the World Hockey League in London in 2017. It was a poor showing. 2 years ago then, he's back And his side are leading after the first quarter. The home of the Netherlands. Certainly a long way to go in this one. Oh, it's a lovely turn. It's not quite on the same wavelength. Over Kemperman. Of the London team in 2012 as well. With silver.
Okay, hands down, hands. 28-23. He's swinging in on the ball.
Marcus down with the free hit. Fired in, Peters in the way for the Netherlands. Still a lot to do, trying to get this ball into a dangerous area, and it's a good press from the Netherlands, forcing Pakistan to near on halfway. Back into their own half they go as well. Points are there first. It's well kept in play, it's incredible control. Oh, well, one back. And now the Netherlands can try and spark. Anticipation was good. And so was that, and now a chance to get in behind. But just out of the reach of Thierry Brinkman. His dad, Jack, was a part of the last time that the Netherlands were Olympic champions, 96 and 2000. He's played Pakistan three times, incidentally, coming into this one. Thierry Brinkman, he's won all three and he scored twice against them too. Doesn't quite come off. Asking a lot of Rashid Mahmood. 141 caps now to his name. John not quite working out for the Netherlands and for Schumann.
Out there.
Success at club level. Schumann with Blumendahl.
Out that way.
Yeah.
Only in the circle do we play those balls.
Good. Mabuta. He's done well. Pakistan looking composed in possession. Away from Peters. Bakker across and dealing with it for the Netherlands like a captain would. Benny Bakker with the captain's armband. Seppi Van As has captain responsibilities as well, but it's Billy Bakker playing at his home ground. That's for Amsterdam Hockey Club. It's a 2018 FIH Player of the Year nomination. It's Otto van Doorn of Belgium won that. Here is Bakker.
Right.
It was fair, according to the umpire. There in time, though, as it runs out of play. Schumann not hanging around. It's the edge of the circle. Peters looking to win it back. It's taken over now here by Bob Devoe. And it's going to be a penalty stroke to the Netherlands. Peters tumbling. And a real opportunity now to get back level. Bob Devoe did well, and then that's the clearest penalty stroke
that you're going to see.
Just on the whistle, guys, when you're ready. Just on the whistle, on the whistle.
The danger, that is Mink van der Weerden. Whoa! He's put it away! One more. Executed with real authority. Chanelli gets the right way, didn't he? But it was just too quick, too good from Ming van der Weerden.
Guys, guys, no whistle to start, yeah?
So we're all square. But it's just what the Netherlands needed. Real clumsy. A challenge it was, wasn't it, by the goalkeeper? And they've won it back, Bakker. Here they come again, the Netherlands got the tails up now. And the reverse it goes! And quick fire goals! Ah! What a finish for Robic. Bjorn Kellerman. That is sensational. Played a real part in dispossessing Pakistan. And how about that for precision? Beyond Amjad Ali. Terrific precision, right into the corner, and how they've changed this round of the Netherlands. Kellerman with a wonderful goal. That was a great success, club level as well, and with Kampong. Onto the group is just Kelly, and now what to Pakistan have in terms of a response of their own, having been set back. There he is again. Robert Kemperman. Billy Bakker. So confident on the ball, back up. Off the vote. Keeps it alive. And from Kemperman. Great hit for the Netherlands to keep this momentum going. Here they come again. Oh, brilliant! And they just can't find an end product. Still, it's alive, and now it's dead. The interplay is so good, such quick thinking. The link up here with Bug DeVoe. Some turnaround. The second quarter for the Netherlands. 2 goals in a minute. So just calm things down a little here, the Netherlands. For a mad few moments, really. Some real confidence about them now as well. Van Ass. Dan Paul, of course, former Dutch national team player and coach. Actually missed the first stage of the Pro League, Sevi Van Ass. He had 6 months away after ankle surgery. the leader of the Euros. Here he is again. Slowing things down a little. Well, the Netherlands looking to try and build something. Main Shaquille. The amount of orange shirts, orange and white shirts back there, making it difficult for Pakistan. Actually get in behind or just even try and break through the lines. Give it away. Ali Shan. Looking for a touch on. Very nearly came off.
No.
Well, they want to refer, I think.
Okay. One. Go away. Okay. One.
It's dangerous. Goalkeeper okay. Hit the ball here.
No problem.
Let's have a look at it then.
Jakub.
Yes, Sean, I'm checking the dangerous ball from the goalkeeper.
Jakub Menschlich is the man in the booth. So was this dangerous? It's the goalkeeper there, and then how high was it? A good reaction first time around by Moritz Visser. And then here. Clearest of views from that particular angle. Every possible angle that Jakub Menschlich has, he'll be looking at. Good one with Sevi Venas in the way of that one, really blocking the shot. But interesting call this. Here it is again. Actually came off a Dutch stick, didn't it? So that's really good reactions from Moritz Visser of Jop de Mol, and then here. Is that deemed dangerous? Because that is what Pakistan are appealing. Again, if they lose this referral, then they will be without a referral.
Sean, I have a decision for you. The ball went dangerously off the goalkeeper, therefore is a penalty corner, and Pakistan keep their referral.
And they've been able to overturn it successfully.
I think it's
that's the dangerous play.
I felt it came off your foot, sort of thing. Then I got by your reaction, I was probably wrong. And so.
So the chance to try and profit from a penalty corner, they have done already in the fifth minute. Through Mubasharani. Ahmed Rizwan going across to provide the injection here. Really seen much of Pakistan since they scored.
Yep.
Here they come. Oh, what a block. What a block. That is what you call putting yourself right on the line, Sandapar.
They want a visit.
And you will feel this all day long. Oh. That is the danger, that's the risk as first defender out.
Well, be aware, on that one, when they were asking for a video, they did work quite a number of...
So a little bit of concern for Max Caldas, I'm sure.
And although he was the one in front, another one or two was free.
Yeah, that's why.
Maybe a stick in the face.
Yeah.
Yeah. Need helping off here, Yobdemol. A helping hand also. You put yourself on the line. That was absolutely blasted into Sandabar. And a fine ovation for a silver medalist at the 2012 Olympic Games.
Dan, will you send one more back? Okay.
Player says that he wants to be an Olympic and World Cup champion. Those two not on my honours list yet.
It's not too long, guys.
I'm hoping it's not too serious. That rules him out for the whole of the weekend.
Okay, let's go, please.
Pakistan with another penalty corner.
Now, come on, boys.
There we go again. Trap is solid. He's kept low, and the deflection sees it into the net. Smiles for Pakistan as they level things up at 2-2. So well worked. Just needed the deftest touch. Well, they'll take that, Pakistan. They've had to soak up a bit of pressure. 25 on the clock. Moritz Visser beaten. What a moment for Pakistan. It's all mainly been about the Netherlands. In this second quarter in particular. When they have been pegged back.
Hold on.
Second time of asking from a penalty corner as well for Pakistan. There's two that they've been given. Ali Gazanfar, who's got it. Looking to respond themselves. But there goes through Kellerman and from Van der Weerden.
14, keep that hand down.
4 minutes remaining in this second quarter. Oh, now then, which way is that going to go? And go Pakistan's way.
I've got it, don't worry.
Falling contest so far. As you know, it's never really dealt between these two, only in two occasions out of in excess of 100 meetings between these two. Has ever finished scoreless. Credit to Pakistan, who've not caved in. The Netherlands piling the pressure on. The ball has to put the brakes on here. Suffered great disappointment. Floris Wortelboer ahead of the World Cup when he picked up a shoulder injury in a training camp in Spain. He didn't make it in the end. Yobdemol. Semi Vanas. Wortelboer again. The Dutch support get behind their team. Their voice is known. Wortelboer back for Vanas. Yobdemol. Thank you.
Two to go until half time. The Netherlands able to break down Pakistan's resistance ahead of the break. Oh, nicely taken. Plenty of options in there. Use of the back of the stick. Reason why the whistle has been blown.
16.
Now they can create the space so easily, so quickly. So brutally quickly as well. Chance for Imabuta to turn. Face forward and attack this Dutch defence. Minister Hoist doing enough. And now Van Aas for Peters. Two alongside him in the circle. If any of them can be found, Sammy Van Aas couldn't take it with him. Pakistan doing just enough. Tight spot for Pakistan, and they can bring it clear now through Umabuta. Get that pass right, and something really could have been on there for Ayash Ahmed. Nudge on, might work out as we enter the final seconds of the first half. Towards the circle he goes, towards Peters. He goes once more in towards Bakker. Pakistan able to deal with it, and that should be that, and is. What a first half. Wonderful entertainment here in Amsterdam. Pakistan shocking the Netherlands with the opening goal through Mubashir Ali. Quick fire goals, two in a minute. Into the second quarter through Ming van der Veer and a penalty stroke, and then Bjorn Kellerman with a wonderful solo goal of his own. Ali Gazanfar equalising for Pakistan. And at halftime, all to play for in this first game between these two nations. Thrilling entertainment so far. Netherlands 2. Pakistan 2.
Thank you. Ik ben Jan van der Bij. Ik ben Ruud om te trainen voor de Olympische Spelen in Tokio.
Welcome back to the Wagener Hockey Stadium, where it's 2-2 between the Netherlands and Pakistan. The first game between these two, the double headers over the weekend to determine who goes to Tokyo and who doesn't. Goals from Kellerman and from Van der Veerden for the Netherlands, but it was Pakistan who shocked the Dutch with the first goal of the match and then the equaliser. Both of their goals have come courtesy of penalty quarters. Really good crowd here at the Wagener Stadion in what has been a fairly gloomy and a pretty breezy day here in Amsterdam. Well, that's not taking anything away from the quality out there between the Netherlands and Pakistan today. Pakistan got off to the best of starts. Mubashir Ali with the penalty corner. That threw a real spanner in the works. Dispatched magnificently well. And then the Netherlands started to pile on some pressure. Their penalty corner moments, but they've not been effective as yet, despite the firepower that they have. And then this is how the penalty stroke came about for Van der Veerden to execute, after Peters had been sent tumbling, and right in the corner from Mink van der Veerden to make it 1-1. Then Kellerman started the breakaway. He nicked it back, got it back then from Bakker, and on the reverse, a finish of absolute precision. But then back came Pakistan just before half time. First penalty corner was blocked superbly well by Xander Bart, who took a knock for his troubles, had to be carried off. And then the second penalty corner was deflected in. Deflected in by Ali Gazanfar 5 minutes before the break. So 2-2, and certainly all to play for in this Olympic qualifier. Stats and facts about what has gone on. 2 goals each, 6-3 in terms of efforts for the Netherlands, more in the way of circle penetrations and just nudging ahead when it comes to possession. But Pakistan have taken their moments, certainly from penalty corners. A disciplined performance so far by both teams. No cards thus yet brandished. So Stocky entertaining the Dutch mascot. Well, they'll be hoping to be rocking the crowd when they come back out, the Dutch support. We're going to have a word with Max Caldas, the Netherlands coach. He's just getting ready to talk to us. And let's go downstairs and hear from Max Caldas.
Max Caldas, it's an interesting match so far, but the scoreline 2-2, it may be not the thing you were hoping for.
Well, we know they can play hockey, so I think that we need to be very aware that we need to actually improve our scoring chances. I think we had we didn't do enough with what we had, and they did pretty much 100% with what they got. So I think we need to be much more aware of how we get into their circle and just try to convert our chances.
But did you tell your players how to solve this?
Nothing, just actually keep on playing, actually pick up the tempo of the game, you know, just play faster, play the first pass you see, you know, play forward, and actually that's what we spoke about.
To the point, as always, Max Caldas. Play forward, not the first pass you see. The message from the coach. took over in 2014, having led the women's team to Olympic success in London 2012. He's been in the Netherlands, Max Caldas, since he was 20 years of age. Came over young and taking the country to his heart. Let's get a viewpoint from Pakistan.
What do you think of the match so far?
Yeah, it's going good. The public, the spectators, they are enjoying. It's a good hockey from both the teams. First half, it's four goals. And to me, you know, it's the best hockey of the world. There's some skills, some tactics. And I hope the next 30 minutes will also go in this piece.
For the most people here, the scoreline 2-2 is a surprise. Is it for you?
It's a game. I always say we are here to give best performance. The result doesn't matter. The best team will win. Who plays the best game, they will have a good chance to win.
Good luck in the second half.
Thanks.
Well, they've taken their chances when they come about. And you can't ask more than that, really. 2-2. So we get the second half underway here in Amsterdam. Wants it to be a different Netherlands team in their approach. Wants it to be a little bit more faster, Max Caldas, get it forward a lot quicker. As he said, don't be looking for the first pass you see, just go forward. They're taking their chances as well. The Vitton's been dispossessed. Pakistan with a turnover. It's been breathless at times. The chase is on here into the corner.
On the line.
Come on, Brett, winning the foot race.
Dania. Yeah, you're good.
Switch of play doesn't work for Pakistan. Off the foot. Just struck him on the foot, on the below the knee. Ayash Ahmed for Pakistan. It's its way into the circle,
30.
But.
It's got to be a 16, and he's more than five.
I look for the important ones in the circle, yeah? You let me know if I miss that one.
Sammy Vadas. There's Yibi Anson, Bakker, Janssen, losing his footing here, managed to win the long corner, Yibi Anson here.
Two balls, guys. Okay, get that one off. Wait.
Two balls, so the moment. In fact, it is to be free hit rather than a long corner. Here's Janssen again. His appearance at the Pro League, first involvement since 2017 with the first team. The Cape Town Summer Series. Whose foot did that come off?
Two of them, yeah.
Netherlands, one of the great hockey nations, always play in front of passionate support, whether it's here in Amsterdam or anywhere else in the country. Great experience of being in Rotterdam and in Breda as well. Their finest performances played in front of a home crowd And they beat the world champions in the Pro League, Belgium. Sensationally in Den Bosch. John, effective. Vega. Preuser. Keep things ticking here. We've not really seen much of Mirko Preuser. Here is again. Is it a fairly quiet afternoon, Mirko Preuser?
Just looking to watch.
It's described as being addicted to goals, Mirko Preuser. Goal scoring opportunities. Wanted to be a little bit more clinical. Max Kaldas helping his team in this second half.
And then just call him out early.
Play on!
Play! Oh, sorry.
And Seppi Van Aas. Giving it back. Mr. Huss. Forced all the way back to halfway here, in well inside their own half. Van de Beerden. Sander Bart's okay now after he took a real bang to the leg earlier in the half. Earlier in the game, I should say. Flash of the cross there, Peters and Preuser. Van Aas. Flashed across. Thierry Brinkman. Up on his feet now, having started the game, sat down in calmer manner. Jansen again. Haven't really been able to link up with the front line in this second half so far, the Netherlands. It's just a case of being a lot more patient, forcing the issue too much. Rashid Mahmoud. Taken over now by Ali Shan. It's the right flank to keep this low and into the circle, looking for a touch off a Netherlands defender illegally, and it is to be a penalty corner for Pakistan, and the Netherlands will know just how dangerous Pakistan can be. The deflection onto the foot of Van de Beerden, and he had no idea. No idea at all.
Yeah, I'm just saying, the ball away afterwards, I know. We're not talking about the first decision. We're saying, once the decision...
After a bright start from the Netherlands, the start of this third quarter, Pakistan with the first chance. A penalty corner situation here in the second half.
Okay.
Dan, I've had a word with Ben.
Here they go again. Trap is good. They're looking for a touch again, and they've done it again. Oh, talk about being so strong at a set piece. The Netherlands undone again from a Pakistan penalty corner. Just the most delicate touch from the captain, Mohamed Rizwan.
That's just Valentin Chenoagu's way.
Yeah.
With the injection and then his direct approach back towards goal, Mohamed Rizwan. And it is totally taken Moritz Visser and the Netherlands by surprise again. 3-2. Amazing.
Evelyn.
Charge, 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 come on! Come on!
Wait, wait!
Back in front again, Pakistan. They took the lead originally at 1-0. What a matchup. That's the thing, we've got to do it all again tomorrow. Goes for a well and sit down as well. 158th cap. Struggling with a little bit of injury ahead of these matches. He didn't play in one of the games against Germany. A player who does play his trade in the Netherlands too. A club level. No attacking touch. Dorana. Oh, loads of space here. Oh!
Seven.
Fired right across from a player who has already scored today in Kellerman, who's already scored sensationally today. And nearly had another one. Well won back, Peters. Bob to vote. Forward thinking for the Netherlands here, although it's been a rather solid foundation from Pakistan, despite those two quickfire goals that they did concede, one being a silly penalty stroke conceded. Second, a moment of brilliance from Kellerman. Well taken down by Kemperman. And here come Pakistan. Rahman Butt. Ali Shan twisting and turning and getting away from his defender. Just put an arm on the back. The first infringement from Glenn Schuurman.
Over there. That's good.
Pakistan in front with five to go in this third quarter.
Then 28 orange and 16 of a physical there, but I think it's all still.
Just wanting some more. Max Caldas. Here's Baka. Quickly on. He get on the end of the return, he can't. Just remember, Pakistan, before this game, against the Netherlands, haven't played a competitive game since the World Cup. A year ago. Extraordinary.
Have you seen what's gone there? Hey, hey.
Ali Shan again. Can't get away from Baka. Although the free hit belongs to Pakistan.
Why is he saying something happened? Yeah, he's saying he just ran a block on him. After the ball, just look behind him.
Not what I saw, but
yeah.
Nothing.
Okay, thank you, Jakob.
Mapai's just getting some confirmation about it. It's a little coming together with Mako Proiser.
Yeah.
So he should have had a decision go his way. Wanted to be one of the 12 teams to qualify for Tokyo. Japan, of course, is host nation already there. Also, we've won continental titles already there as well. Argentina, Pan Am champs. South Africa, the African Olympic qualifiers, Belgium, of course, European champions, and Australia, Oceania champions. Pakistan here, looking to score another one.
Obstruction.
But here come the Dutch, they're not hanging around. They are behind. And Poyser squared across.
Okay.
Just needed the pass to be right. And surely we would have been looking at 3-3. Nice run at the other end, wasn't it? Where is the skipper? Mohamed Rizwan. Use some wits here. This is played in by Shaman, and it's going to be nudged out. Moritz Visser. One corner. Mohamed Rizwan again.
Guys, keep a hand out.
Finding moments, aren't they? They are finding moments that are causing the Netherlands issues. But having played so very little, it's been a little tricky, you suspect, to try and keep an eye on the development of Pakistan in preparation for this.
Clear, orange. Good.
Not played many games. But how they have turned up here this afternoon. Be one of the talking points of the weekend. Pakistan can hold on here and take a lead into the second match. Oh, well seized upon. Faker caught out, and here come Pakistan. Just able to get another one. Ayash Ahmad just can't find his target in the centre, and Sanderbart can tidy up for the Dutch. Nim van der Veerden. His injury setbacks in his career, particularly his ankle. Clock ticking down. Incredible, incredible here in Amsterdam. Pakistan retaking the lead. That man's goal has nudged them back in front again. And once more it has come from a penalty corner, the goal. Three of their goals have come from APC. And you have to say, talk about being clinical. And the Netherlands with some work to do in the final quarter. They are behind by 3-2.
I'm always saying
pretty much everything so far.
Performance.
Plenty going on out there, plenty of drama. And Pakistan on the verge of causing a stir. Trying all they could, the Netherlands. But in the end, it was Pakistan with the goal and the captain having injected. Coming up with the goods at the near post. Flashing across there was Kalaman, who's already scored today. But Pakistan, they are showing no fear against Max Kaldas's side. And the advantage was with them as we come into the final 15 minutes. Who saw this coming, by the way? A pragmatic view from Kwasi Junaid at the start of this one. Even at halftime, he was just talking about how the crowd have been entertained by both teams, and they have. But as he said, the Netherlands, who they're up against today, are the best in the world, and his team are leading in their own backyard. So, Pakistan, what have you got for the next quarter of an hour? The Netherlands, what have you got for the next 15 minutes? Well, we're going to be going into the second game on a knife edge. The score could be fairly important for Pakistan if they were to get the next goal and maybe able to take a more handsome lead, if you like, into the second game, something to really build on. Or will it be the Netherlands that will strike back? Where is Mohamed Rizwan? Rolling back the years, really. Scoring today is actually over a year since his last goal at the Asian Champions Trophy when he scored against South Korea. Returned by Mubashir Ali, who scored the opening goal of this contest from a penalty corner in 5 minutes. Pakistan, who didn't qualify for Rio, the last Olympic Games, 2016, 1992, the last time that they won a medal. The world ranking of 17, and they are defying the odds against the third best nation in hockey. Rashid Mahmood, come in possession. This is Umar Bhutta. Miscommunication there. A block there was. De Hoist getting on with it. Across it goes. Samyad Ali doing just enough. The optimal wins it. Pakistan, I thought that might have been a little dangerous. Free hit goes the Netherlands way. Vortelboer, Peters, Cameron still. A long corner. Since for the next 12 minutes, it's going to be a case of the Netherlands being the team who will dominate. It might just be an element of this. Pakistan will sit in and be a real test of their defensive resolve. To the corner he goes. Kept in play. The possession this from the Netherlands. Van der Weerden getting further advanced. Vortelboer having to go backwards. The press is good from Pakistan. Frustrating the Netherlands here. Oh, and then the error comes from De Hoist. To relieve that pressure now, Pakistan. The race is on here. Ali Shah. Still he goes on. Which option is he going to be taking here, Ali Shah? From one side of the pitch to the other. The free hit belonging to Pakistan. And they will take this.
On the pitch. Okay, you're good there, but no closer. Okay.
Mabuta, it's gone out of play. Sloppy. He's going to be taking over this. Here come the Netherlands. Stay on the feet, and he's been able to do so, Valentin Vekka. And they just can't find Bob de Voet joining in the attack. Well, it's a stoppage here.
Ben, you want to get in there.
Get Cameron in there. Has just felt one in the face.
Careful there, yeah?
Not you, him.
Dad, just watch his face.
Yeah,
good.
Great defensive work.
All right.
You know, Vega kept on going. He was just played behind Bob Devoogd, wasn't it?
Played the advantage. Okay.
And this is where Kellerman just fell one. Just a grazing of the shoulder to the side of the head.
You can start.
There's nothing intentional about that. Billy Bucker. Back to halfway with Van der Veert. Back from Kemperman.
Jakob, please confirm that's number 6.
Kassan will take that. Frustrated looks on the faces of those Netherlands players.
We are checking.
It's nicely done by Rashid Mahmoud. The lift and the accuracy, the aerial pass. Keeps a play just about, although. Bob Jansen has earned the free hit. Just a little too quick, a little rash in getting things going quickly, chasing things inside the final 10 minutes. They only beat half time in the overall context of things. First of two matches in these qualifiers. Picked up here by Semi Vanas. And will he work out for Kellerman? It will do! It will do in the end for Robert Kellerman! Right place, right time, and we're all square again here in Amsterdam. Although Pakistan will have something to say about things here.
Now we go away, thank you. You're also our captain. Yeah. Hey! Yeah.
Jakob! Over to you, Jakob.
We've got a team referral. They're asking for two things. The first is they're saying a stick tackle by the attacker on the defender at the far post. And the second is they're saying the ball was dangerously in the air. Can you look for both of those for me, please?
Do you want to tell your boys just
to
move away?
I will check the whole situation.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, two things that Pakistan are looking for. Stick tackle and whether it was dangerous also. They're going to be denying Robert Kemperman a goal here today. Which will take him to 49, by the way.
Sean, there is no reason to change your decision. It's a goal and Pakistan lose the referral.
Goal and you lose the referral.
Big moment in the match.
And you lose the referral.
Danger. 3-3. The goal stands. And it's come for Kemperman. Oh, the reaction of Vortelbos says it all, doesn't it? What a wonderful contest. And this is just the first of the two games between these two nations. The pendulum is swung every which way. And now the crowd respond as well. Rashid Mahmoud fires it into the corner. Also, the Netherlands, or Pakistan, I should say, are going to have to be playing against the crowd too. It's a massive shot in the arm for the Netherlands. Uma Buta sticks as the umpires, and so off they go, the Netherlands, and they've got the opportunity to Go left again, the Obnotsu, Sammy Van Ass, came off the foot.
Good, good timing, hold him.
And just a little rushed from the man who's got that equaliser at 3-3. Robert Kemperman. He's winning back here though in the midfield. Oh, this is coming to the end, right on the edge of the circle. Free hit belonging to the Netherlands. It's Vega. And we're going to go long corner. Really, really good to watch this. Is that the bar? Just playing behind, see up the mall. I'm sure the message to both of these teams, more of the same tomorrow, please. But there can only be one winner in one place for Tokyo. Encouraging burst forward by Abdemal. Van Ass. Brinkman doesn't want to give anything away here. Mumput was calm under some real pressure. And here goes Ali Shan. Taking them all on, is he? That's really good poke through the legs. And out behind. Still the intensity is there. The energy is there from both of these teams. Tatsawa Abbas. Oh, Mohamed Rizwan.
Ben, will you attend him? I'm going.
I've already seen Sander Bard in the wars. Today being hit. And it's from his own player here. Tatsawa Abbas. Sander Bard had to be carried off. But, skipper's okay. Just over 5 minutes to go in this one.
That's fine. Yeah. It's not dangerous. Come on, your man's putting himself there. He's fine. He takes that ball, he's happy.
Ali Shan, this is to be another twist to the tail, perhaps. And well won back by Rashid Mahmood. Mohamed Rizwan's okay now, and he's been sent tumbling there by Sander Bard.
Just accidental.
About a meter outside.
That's all it is, according to the umpire. Rashid Mahmood, Mohamed Rizwan. Mabuta. This is Mamuric. Now with Mabuta. Oh, what a turn that is. So brilliantly well. And a penalty corner. As it came back. Sensational skills close to the baseline. And it came back here. It was raised high. And a penalty corner for Pakistan, who have been frightfully good when it comes to these situations.
Rizzi.
Just short of 4 minutes
We're
remaining.
Come on. Okay, here we go then, guys. 3 seconds. Okay, let's go.
Mubashar Ali, a scorer from the PC. Ali Ghazanfar, Mohammed Rizwan has been also. Here they go again! And this time they are foiled by Moritz Visser. So quick down to his right side. Foiling Pakistan on this occasion.
On you.
That's a top save, it really is. Still they ask some questions. Just going to have to stop things as Ming van der Weerden has felt one. The hand, it looks like.
He's happy with that one.
All right.
Yeah, just on the wrist. It's the save again. And a good save it was. Still the danger not over with yet for the Netherlands. Ali Shan. Still he goes. Penalty corner again. This is a real spell for Pakistan.
Put the delivery back off the bat like this. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Do you want the video, Billy?
No,
it's good.
It is.
You can't improve that on purpose. Yeah, but it was just...
That's the problem. So he's playing it for the ball deliberately off the back. Not for the foot.
Okay, busy!
So, here we go again.
Okay, five.
Very difficult for me from here, Billy. Yeah.
Mohammed Rizwan. With the injection. Trap is good. The execution again is magnificent. There is no stopping Pakistan. And penalty corners, and Mimishar Ali, he's got another one.
Yeah, 3 minutes, bud.
Another twist to the
big
tail.
Oh.
Brutally good. His second of the game. Absolutely magnificent. And they've got to do it all again, the Netherlands, to come from behind. Inside final 3 minutes. I've got to be right on song now, defensively, Pakistan.
Stay deep, stay deep.
Yeah.
2014, their last win against the Netherlands.
Just remember, I've got your circle, won't I?
Here is Bart. Into the circle they go. Reverse effort from Kellerman. Oh, that's Bucker.
Play.
And play on, say the officials. Pakistan will take this.
There's 30 metres between you. No, never dangerous.
Final 2 minutes. Coming off a Dutch foot. They'll take this, Pakistan. They'll slow things down as well. Be in no rush to get going quickly. Ali Shan, who's grown into the game. Time against the Netherlands.
Yeah,
keep coming into these games as well. He's making sure you're still in the contest after the first match. So this won't be too alarming for the Netherlands if they are to go into the second game tomorrow behind. Suddenly crank up the pressure a little bit more. Should make for fascinating viewing, as this one has done today. Final minutes we are in now. Pakistan frustrating the Netherlands, just going from side to side, not really going anywhere. Kapruiser has been very, very quiet and on the fringes today. At the moment, this will be for Kwaja Junaid and his team. Long it goes, penalty corner. Kapruiser underneath it. Invading the space as he came down. With 20 seconds or so remaining.
Five.
Not being five. And could this prove to be absolutely crucial for the Netherlands?
Absolutely.
In the overall context of this one. 22 seconds remaining.
We're starting.
Mirko Preusser with the injection. Van der Weerden is there as one of their key threats. Here's the injection. And oh, it's off the frame of the goal. They're going to get another one. Off the foot. Pakistan don't have a referral. And there's going to be a yellow card. Amazing. A yellow card.
You do not have a referral. There's a foot over here.
I think that's just purely down to the reactions of the Pakistan players. They don't have a referral remaining.
Do you want another one to go?
Oh, Van der Weerden. Amazing. Back off the frame of the goal.
You do not have a referral.
And then all drama unfolded.
Go, come on.
Yes. Cannot react like that straight into the face of the umpires. What a finish. What a finish to this one. Van der Weerden waits again. In he comes again. There he is! With probably the last play of the game. Mink van der Weerden does what he does best. A second goal for him today. 4-4 with just 1 second remaining.
Listen, hit the bar, man.
You've talked
Don't
to him.
You just yeah, love this game? Talk about pressure, execution. This place is rocking. And look at the emotion on Mink van der Weerden's face.
Oh. Just stay away, Rat, stay away.
Incredible. What a finish. When they thought they'd possibly lost it with 2 minutes to go when Mubashir Ali scored for Pakistan, but Mink van der Weerden, with his second goal of the match, has managed to rescue something going into the second game tomorrow for the Netherlands. They won't be going behind. They'll be going in level 4-4. What an encounter here in Amsterdam. A match that simply had it all, and they've got to do it all again tomorrow. Incredible at full-time here. Netherlands 4, Pakistan 4. It's a great opportunity just to take a breath. Max Kaldas's side have been through it all. Pakistan have given them one massive, massive scare today. And you have to say, Pakistan deserving of this draw against the Netherlands, which is no mean feat in itself, especially a team who have not played competitively since last year's World Cup. Let's have a look at the best of the action. Mubashir Ali with his first goal of the game. The penalty corner coming on 5 minutes. Penalty stroke dispatched by Van der Weerden on 20, brought things level. And then Bjorn Kellerman, how about this for a finish? Oh, right in the corner to make it 2-1 just a minute later. But then Ali Ghazanfar with a delicate deflection, diverting it in for 2-2. And then Mohamed Rizwan with a deft touch of his own to make it 3-2. The equaliser for the Netherlands for 3-3 came courtesy of Robert Kemperman. And then drama when Mubashir Ali, with 2 minutes to go, gave Pakistan the lead again. And then with a final play, Ming van der Weerden rescuing things for the Netherlands. Oh, let's go through how it all unfolded then in terms of stats. 8-6 with shots, 23-10 circle penetrations for the Netherlands. 52-48 possession and penalty corners, 4 for Pakistan. And they were able to score from them too. What a game, what a game. Well, they'll soak up the applause, both teams will, after what has been an extraordinary contest. The energy, the amount of work that has been put into that one, and to think that they'll have to do it again in 24 hours, less than now. It should be an incredible game again, we hope. And it can reach the same levels as it has here this afternoon in Amsterdam. Pakistan, hats off to you. Mauled by Germany in the warm-ups in two matches in Mönchengladbach. But here in Amsterdam, they have defied the odds and soak it all up, take it all in, because they have given the Netherlands a fright. They have given them a fight. Ming van der Weerden, the hero of the hour. And Jakub taking it all in. They're all about trying to... I'm trying to recover now for these players. Such is the demands of these qualifiers. And whether they are able to repeat it all again tomorrow, the same levels. We will soon find out. We're going to get some reaction in a minute. And Mohamed Rizwan is ready to talk to us after what has been a pulsating encounter between the Netherlands and Pakistan. Here is Mohamed Rizwan, ready to talk to us.
Rashid Mahmoud, 4-4 in a spectacular match. How is it to play such a wonderful match?
I think it's a great game for the crowd, for the both teams. Both teams played very well, and it was a great performance from our side. The boys, they played very proudly and bravely. I already know they have number three. I think we prepared very well in the first game, and we displayed very well performance on the today. But unfortunately, we couldn't get the 3 points. That was very important. But the way we played, I am happy with the performance of the boys.
For most people, it could be a surprise that Pakistan is level to the Netherlands. Is it for you?
Yeah. We know they have the great players and a good team, but still, this is the last chance for both teams. And when you have last chance, you do everything what you can do. I think we're looking for that tomorrow. We have to recover well and look for the mistakes we do today. And the weaknesses of them, we will see how can we handle that tomorrow again.
Yeah, nothing decided yet. Looking forward to tomorrow.
Yeah, it's the last chance, as I told before. And we are going again tomorrow with bravely. We're playing with the heart and playing for our nation and for the glory of our hockey. It's very important, the competition, to play in the Olympics. That's the best competition in the world. And I hope we do great tomorrow again. Thank you.
Well, that was Rashid Mahmoud giving his reactions there, not the skipper, Mohamed Rizwan. And let's try and get some viewpoints from the Netherlands side of things. They certainly did play with heart and pride, did Pakistan. Well, what about the Netherlands? And what did they feel? Went on out there over those four quarters. Billy Bakker is ready to talk to us.
Your thoughts of the match?
I think I'm a bit disappointed. We had a preparation for the last 2 weeks, and we had some strategies to do today. And in my opinion, we didn't accomplish that. So yeah, was a bit disappointed. So we need to stick the heads together, analyze what we did wrong, and make sure that tomorrow it should be better.
Can you already point to something what went wrong?
Yeah, I can't say that because that's a specific way of playing against Pakistan. But we can hurt them more, and this is the way Pakistan wants to play, and that's not the way we want to play. So I can't say anything about tactics. So.
In the end, you maybe should be satisfied with a draw, since it was only in the last minute.
Yeah, of course, we should be satisfied with a draw. If we are with this quality of the team, and that's not to be arrogant, but we should win this game, and we should dominate this game. And in my opinion, we didn't do that, and we should be very satisfied with the equalizer of Mink, of course. And like I said, we have to stick the heads together and make sure tomorrow it must be 200% better.
Tomorrow is do or die.
Definitely. Otherwise, it's a game over situation. So yeah, it's a do or die game. Absolutely.
The thoughts of Billy Bakker, the skipper of the Netherlands. This is what's coming up with Spain and France locked at 3-3 from their first game yesterday. And they'll be taking part in Valencia and Canada and Ireland to come later in Vancouver. Still so much to be determined this weekend. Great drama here in Amsterdam. And we've got it all to go tomorrow, as the Netherlands will meet Pakistan again. And if it's anything like today, we should be in for something thrilling. It's finished 4-4 here, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Bye for now.